Welcome to Law You Should Know. The law affects every aspect of our lives, our home, our jobs, and our recreational activities. Now you can learn about the law and how to protect yourself against the loss of your liberty or property. Learn how to stand up for your rights and seek compensation when you have been wronged. Your host for Law You Should Know is attorney Kenneth J. Landau with the Mineola Law Firm of Shane, Dock, Stanisi, and Corker. He's a member of the Committee on Professional Ethics of the Bar Association of Nassau County and counsel to the Nassau Academy of Law. And now, here is your host for Law You Should Know, attorney Kenneth J. Landau.
Hi, this is Ken Landau, and welcome to Law You Should Know, now in its 30th year. Today, our guest is Elliot Bogod, and we'll be talking about how to get rich in real estate, and you'll receive at least 20 different tips for taking advantage of opportunities in today's market. Elliot, welcome to Law You Should Know.
Hello, Ken, and thanks for having me on your program.
And one of your tips is just to get to know, the real estate market. So just tell us about that.
Sure. So the markets in New York, I specialize in Manhattan, in New York City area, and the markets, as you know, they are cyclical, they are up and down, and now we are in a buyer's market. The market changed dramatically in the last 4 years, since 2015, when the market was highest, that was a seller's market. Now we are in a absolutely different market. We are now in a buyer's market, and it's good for buyers to come and buy, and that's what we are in now.
And compared to other returns, it might can under the right circumstances, it can be good to put your part of your money into some form of real estate investment.
That's absolutely right. The money doesn't make you good returns by being in your bank accounts, and as most in the CDs, you get 1.5-2% nowadays. So it's you can take advantage of favorable markets and invest your money into real estate and get returns and appreciation.
Are there some other magic words that are often used in real estate investment?
Yes, my book has a lot of secrets and tips and also magical words. Magic words are such as equity, debt, recourse, non-recourse. All those words mean a lot when you doing day-to-day business and you have to know all the aspects of real estate, and those words mean a lot to you as an investor.
Okay, can you just tell us what equity debt means?
Sure, equity is your down payment and your appreciated real estate. That's your portion of real estate at any point. That's the difference between your debt and property value. And so this is the active participation, if you will. This is active. This is your money in the transaction. Your money you have in the property, that money you can always get out when you sell. Part of it you can take out when you refinance. And that's equity.
And what are some methods for evaluating the locations for your real estate investments?
So locations are really important, and as you know, it's three magic words in real estate, and actually it's location, location, and location. And when it comes to investment, it's one of the important things to consider. The area where you invest, I suggest to all my investors to go to see the property, to see the neighborhood, to know your neighbors, to know restaurants, infrastructure, trends, to come daytime, nighttime, weekdays and weekends, and know exactly what's going on in the neighborhood.
And do you believe it's important to buy in neighborhoods that that are going to be the next big thing, that are up and coming? You know, so a neighborhood that's already very fancy is going to be expensive.
Ken, it's interesting that the neighborhood we didn't know much about came to be what it is now, and it's only recently it became known, Hudson Yards, and we only know and see Hudson Yards East. Hudson Yards West, which is not even built yet, will come to fruition in next 10 years, and we see and hear so much about that new neighborhood, and it's completely changed the area, and it's probably the most expensive area now in the city. In a couple of years ago, we didn't even know about this neighborhood.
And the idea is to figure out what the next big thing is going to be.
Yes, I always advise my clients to look at the subway, transportation, points of interest, schools, trends. Many years ago, Upper East Side, Upper West Side was most popular area, and nobody knew about Tribeca or Village or Lower East Side. Now those neighborhoods are trending, they're changing. A lot of new construction, new developments, conversions are happening. So they all offer a lot of opportunities to investors.
And also some of the railroads have stations near the, you know, that get people into New York City very quickly, and that can always be an upcoming neighborhood.
Yes, I agree. New Yorkers are always looking for new restaurants, new places of interest, trendy shops, and they're following new and exciting developments. So the trendy areas are always hot.
And what are different types of residential investments?
So something to consider in New York, of course, well-known condos, co-ops, townhouses, retail condos. It's some of the easy entrance markets, easy to invest properties, and that's what I recommend to my clients when residential market is not so hot and it's a buyer's market. It's good to see what are the values, to buy at the lower point and to buy in a buyer's market.
And are condominiums more investor-friendly?
Yes, for condominiums are offering exactly what the houses are offering. It's a property that you invest in, and condominium cannot refuse your tenants. They don't have your tenants will not go to interviews as for co-ops. It's completely opposite. They will have to. So co-ops are not so investor friendly. It's mostly for prime residences. I like townhouse markets. It's now also offering a lot of deals. Townhouses in New York are a hot commodity. It's only about 5,000-6,000 townhouses in New York, and they offer a lot of opportunities.
And sometimes in the neighborhoods that are becoming gentrified, they especially, you know, townhouses or small homes offer very good value.
I agree. Townhouses that are vacant can offer to investor an opportunity to convert and to make a one family or two family house, and it offers opportunity to be in a real estate tax class which is protected. And I write a lot about it in my book Get Rich in Real Estate. I offer a chapter on townhouses and what they can offer to an investor.
And you also believe it's important to get detailed advice on investing. What does an investor need advice about in terms of real estate investing?
So you have to have your team in place. You have to know the real estate taxes. You have to know about insurance. You have to know about reinvestment, possibility to do 1031 exchange. All that is provided by your attorney, your broker, your tax advisor, insurance broker, title company. You need environmental company when it comes to purchase. So all those professionals you have to have in place.
And you also might need some kind of broker, someone to help with financing the deal. A mortgage broker or something.
I absolutely agree. Can today, especially they cutting interest rates for the third time this year, and maybe more interest cuts are coming. Interest rates are low. You always should consider getting a mortgage, and interest rates are lowest in years for the properties.
And you have the security of the property itself.
Part of your team. Sorry?
No, you have the security and the value of the property itself helping to guarantee your investment.
Yes, the property values are holding strong and properties appreciate. They guarantee returns if you hold and if you sell in a higher market, in the seller's market.
And sometimes you can find a more valuable use for that property, or as you mentioned before, dividing it up.
Yes, dividing, changing the... Sometimes your zoning offers you to do a mixed use use of the property. Sometimes you can convert commercial property to residential. Sometimes you can do more than one store. You can do retail. Retail sector nowadays is affected, but if you are on an avenue, you always have tenants. Retail is always, in New York, is a big business. You can sell retail as a condo. You can buy a retail condo. I like those for my clients.
And this is for a retail condo for office. And is it important to check on transportation, access, and parking for commercial areas?
Yes, it's always important because you have traffic, you have employees that getting to work, and you have different shifts, and the effect of transportation always affect your property value.
And parking is important because it makes it more valuable.
Yes, parking, especially in New York, parking is expensive. By the way, garage business is one of the very prosperous business. The public garages making a lot of money, and some of the investors are choosing this class of properties for investment. And banks are offering very low rates to finance parking garages as well.
Okay. Elliot, we have to take a short break now. We'll return in a minute. And when we do, we'll find out from Elliot more ways to get rich in real estate. You're listening to Law You Should Know on 90.3 WHPC, the voice of Nassau Community College. We'll be back in a moment.
This portion of programming on WHPC is brought to you on behalf of the Nassau County Bar Association, who wants you to know about ADR, Alternate Dispute Resolution, which can help you avoid costly, lengthy, and uncertain litigation in court. By resolving disputes through mediation or arbitration, it gives you control over who decides your case. A mediator helps all parties to reach an agreement they can live with, or an arbitrator selected by the parties hears and decides the case. Your attorney can still represent you, but you control who decides your case. ADR is faster, easier and less stressful than fighting in court, and it is a great way to resolve divorce, employment, or commercial disputes. ADR is now offered through the Nassau County Bar Association. Find out more about how ADR can help resolve your dispute by calling 516-747-4070 or visit nassaubar.org.
Once again, we continue with Law You Should Know. From the Mineola Law Firm of Shane, Docs, Denise, Corker, and Sauer, here is attorney Kenneth J. Landau.
Hi, this is Ken Landau, and welcome back to Law You Should Know. We're talking with Elliot Bogod, and that's B-O-G-O-D, and he's the author of Get Rich in Real Estate. We're talking about possible real estate investments as an alternate way to make money. Keep in mind, whatever you hear on this show is presented as information only. You have to talk to your lawyer, accountant, and financial advisor to see if it makes sense for you and to evaluate the pros and cons. Elliot, you mentioned also that using multiple strategies and tactics and techniques is important for building wealth through investments. Can you explain that?
Yes, Ken. So I always suggest to my clients to consider refinancing instead of selling. And there is sometimes another alternative to take a partner. JV partners is always a way to have a property going and to have your alternative instead of selling. Selling of real estate is always something to consider, and you can consider 1031 exchange, so you can find the property. You'll have your 90 days to find the identify the property and 180 days to reinvest. So this is always another alternative to reinvest into other properties.
And as you mentioned before, it's always important to be aware about the mortgage market, what type of mortgages you might qualify for, what the real estate and income taxes are and the consequences, and of course, zoning laws.
Right. So in New York, zoning will allow you to have your property in a, for example, in our zoning, you might have a R10 zoning is favorable zoning for the hotel. Some of the clients that I have taking advantage of R10 zoning. M1 zoning is also good for hotels. Most of the C zonings good for the hotel development and hotel conversions. So it's always good to have advice on what you can do in your zoning and to have a best use and to up the property value by taking advantage of your zoning.
Can you always use it for a parking lot while you're, you know, working out the permits or a buyer for more lucrative use?
Oh, yes. Parking lots are always a good business, and it's always bringing revenues. So you can hold it as a rented parking lots and get your plans together and develop the property after you making money in the parking business.
And you mentioned considering JV when buying real estate. Can you explain what a JV is?
JV is a partnership. So you take a partner, general partner or limited partner, and if you are general partner, you basically operate the business, and limited partner is your money partner. So sometimes you, if your partner is your active partner as you are, you take him as a working partner and you do business together. Sometimes your partner is not active in the business and only investing as a partner, and that's a JV,
and that's
a limited partner.
And that's one way to do it if you don't have the if you're not interested in running the day-to-day operations, you'd rather just make the investment and get your returns.
Exactly. So for a partner who is not active in the business, it's a passive investment, and there is a lot of opportunities that's offering passive investments. So we have a lot of investors who come to us who are looking to invest money into existing opportunities, and we help them to do that as well.
And again, you have to evaluate how worthy that investment is, and hopefully it's going to go up and be able to pay you interest or dividends in the future.
That's correct. In a certain market, you go after the certain class of property, and every 6 months in New York, you see something new. Some properties are more trendy than others, and today, office market, I would say, because of the strong economy, you have your office market for years already, you have vacancies are very minimal, and offices are doing really well.
And again, access to public transportation or parking or the main streets makes them even more valuable.
Yes, location is always a paramount. And what's also very important is to get your right price for the property. That's one of the big advantages. If you buy at the right price and in any market, your property will... you'll know that you bought it at the right price.
And maybe have some advance commitments from tenants.
Oh, yes. It's very important to hold on to good tenants, to those that make the property great. And you renew leases, you do special incentives for your tenants. I always advise my clients to keep good tenants.
And why is cash flow important?
Cash flow is, that's what keeps your property going in any market. So that's your passive income. Cash flow is always, your balance sheet is important to a bank. You can refinance it. You can take your equity line of credit. You can do a lot. And it's all based on your cash flow.
And, of course, it's going to be cash in your pocket if the cash exceeds your, you know, expenses for the loan and other expenses of the building.
Oh, yes. That's a dream of every investor in town, to get your property paid off and to have your cash flow. If you have no mortgage, that's the ultimate way of retiring and... leaving that property to yourself.
Do you have many chapters about analyzing the market?
Yes. So there is a few chapters about markets, and particularly I'm writing about seller's markets, buyer's markets, and even the stagnation. So it's all here in my book.
Okay, and is your book, how can someone get a hold of your book?
So my book is available on Amazon. It became an international bestseller since May this year. It's a recent book, and it's available on as an audiobook on iTunes, and it will be available starting next week in Barnes & Noble.
And again, just for anyone who's looking for it, it's Get Rich in Real Estate, and it's by Elliot Bogod. It's B-O-G-O-D.
That's correct.
And, of course, you said it'll be available in Barnes & Noble, so it probably makes a very good holiday gift.
Yes, holidays are approaching. You can buy it for yourself, or you can buy it as a gift.
And it's good for help to someone start the new year on the right foot. What else would you like to suggest in terms of due diligence?
Ken, that's the very important in any transaction. You cannot overlook and underestimate importance of the due diligence. You only buy when you absolutely must buy and after you did your due diligence. Don't be afraid to walk away from the property after you discovered something that wasn't disclosed. It's very important to know all aspects of the purchase.
Okay.
And that's only the way to do it, only to study about the property and do your due diligence.
Okay, we have limited time left, but why is depreciation so important?
Interestingly enough, depreciation is only known in America, in the United States. In Europe, there is no depreciation. In other parts of the world, there is no depreciation. You can depreciate your property through 27 and a half years, and you can do it in your commercial investments, and it's a very healthy way to take advantage of the taxation, and this is always a way to have your write-offs at the tax time.
And as you mentioned, there should be you should always walk away if something doesn't seem right. And just tell us your website, Elliot, and where people can find other articles you've written for Forbes that are on your website, and more about your book.
Yes, Ken. My website is BroadwayRealty.com. That's BroadwayRealty.com. We are located in Manhattan at 150 Broadway in downtown. We are in business for, 20 years. You can find more information on my website, BroadwayRealty.com.
Okay.
And social media is there as well.
And just as I mentioned earlier, whatever you've heard is presented for information only. You should check with your own professionals, including your own attorney, before investing. And if you missed any portion of the show, the podcast is available at nccradio.org, along with other podcasts of past Law You Should Know broadcast. And Elliot's book is Get Rich in Real Estate, and his last name is Bogod, and it'll be available in Barnes & Noble next week. Thank you for listening to Law You Should Know on 90.3 WHPC, the voice of Nassau Community College. And please join us next week at the same time for another show on Law You Should Know.